There is a public high school in California where no official tardiness records are kept. There's no dress code. Students are not required to attend study hall. Seniors and sophomores may sit side by side in the same academic courses. And a casual visitor feels that the students are genuinely interested in learning, not in the end of period bell. The name of this incredible public institution is Henry M. Gunn High School, and the name of its principal is Dr. Robert McLean. This quotation from the Los Altos Town Crier in 1966 continued, describing Gunn's college-like campus, set in the midst of old California oak trees that sheltered the school, with landscaped lawns that provided a respite from classes, and the fountain in the center of the main quad that afforded endless opportunities for entertainment. Dr. Henry M. Gunn was hired as superintendent in 1950 to revolutionize education in Palo Alto. When Dr. Gunn retired in 1961, the school board, led at that time by David Packard, announced that the district's next secondary school would be named Henry M. Gunn Senior High School in honor of his achievements in the field of education. Dr. Gunn espoused educational individuality and experimentation, and many of his ideas were implemented at the new school.
You know, I guess I'm back to the point of really being concerned about individual students of all kinds and trying to meet all kinds of different needs. And then, of course, the other thing about that is how different Gunn High School, you know, reading Henry M. Gunn talking about high schools can be different. They don't have to be the same. And boy, has this place been different, hasn't it, Bob? Bob McLean, from the beginning?
And this provided an opportunity for some youngsters that normally wouldn't find them.
That you wouldn't find in class, right? And I think it helped inside teachers as well, because those particular kids, it motivated them, and they cleaned up their act, and they maybe still sat in the back of the classroom like adult, but they didn't, no trouble, and they tried to do their work,
About the motorcycle.
About the next, and he set down the rules. You can be in one block, you can't be in the other. I'm not going to kick you for 12 weeks. There are a whole bunch of other people who want to be in there.
Yeah. And again, that philosophy, it wasn't just the PE department, it was really throughout the school. The English department has always had a rich elective program, whereas I think a lot of American high schools are English 1, 2, 3, 4, freshman, sophomore, American Lit junior year, English Lit senior year. We've had just a rich history, and it continues to this day. Boy, in the heyday of electives, we had things like science fiction. We had literature of rock at one
literature
point
of
in the
rock.
1970s. The students would sit over, they had huge speakers put in one of the music rooms, and the students would sit in there, and then they would spend hours debating implications of lyrics like "Hey Jude, Hey Jude, Hey Jude, Hey Jude." I'm being satirical. Rich history of electives, and I don't know. Can you think of other ways in which Gunn has really made it a point to cater to individual students?
One of the biggest entrepreneurs that we had on our staff was Ron Cooper. He did some things in the shop that were unreal, and that you couldn't do in a normal shop because the teacher wouldn't let that happen. But Ron did, you know?
In 1962, the school board voted to open Palo Alto's third high school on land previously obtained from Stanford University. The groundbreaking ceremony was held in October 1963, and by September 1964, the school would be open and ready, or almost ready, for the students and staff. At the groundbreaking ceremony for the new school, Dr. Gunn said this: "The American High School is a most unique institution since it serves all children of all people. Gunn High School will be a prototype of high schools of the future and will be among the finest facilities in the country. Within 9 years, both of my grandchildren will be students in this school. My wife and I feel that we can speak for the thousands of parents and grandparents of students who will attend this school in saying that we are proud to see this institution added to our school district. The administration and board could not have made a finer choice in its selection of Bob McLean as principal of Gunn High School. This school, or any school, is only as good as the people in it. Dr. Robert McLean, at the relatively young age of 38, was hired by the district in 1963 to lead the new school. Dr. McLean was joined by administrators and teachers, all handpicked by him, who spent a whole year creating the school that they envisioned, a high school that resembled an institution of higher education. As the Town Crier article claimed, there are several reasons why Gunn is such a fine, fascinating school. Its excellent faculty, the beautiful oak-studded grounds, and architecture which doesn't feel dreary and institutional. But, unmistakably, one man is responsible, Dr. Robert McLean, who in everything he's done there has managed to establish this atmosphere, one that we can only describe as a feeling of encouragement. Dr. McLean, upon announcing his resignation in June 1970, wrote, "Gunn is a unique school in many ways. Our physical plant is one of the finest, but perhaps even finer is the teaching-learning atmosphere we have been able to develop. The mutual respect among the students, staff, and administration has been, in my judgment, the primary ingredient that has made my tenure at Gunn so professionally satisfying and personally pleasant." 50 years later, one sees that while most of Gunn's oak trees have disappeared, the lawns and fountain are no more, the Gunn sign has changed and the buildings have aged, the spirit that is Gunn, innovation, mutual respect, inclusiveness, and a sense of fun, continues to thrive. We see that spirit in the classroom. Students and staff from many different countries and ethnic backgrounds working hard together in their shared pursuit of knowledge. We see that spirit outside of the classroom, places like the Center Quad where friendships are cemented, jokes are shared, food is eaten, homework finished, music played, and dances held. Club Day on the Center Quad especially highlights Gunn's inclusiveness and mutual respect as clubs celebrate everything from Pokemons to beadwork, horticulture to the future business leaders of America, Wiccan awareness, gun rights, and math and chess, to diversity in groups like the Black Student Union and the Gay Straight Alliance. We see that spirit on the playing fields as teams compete on fields, courts, courses, and pools, athletes and coaches working together and having fun together, and sometimes competing together, as with the annual Clash of the Titans. We see the spirit as students and sometimes staff pursue the arts. It might be writing, producing, staging and acting, creating magic in Spangenberg Auditorium and the Little Theater throughout the years. With luck, we may see one of the highlights of the year, the annual choir staff musical. It might be Titans creating in other art forms, sculpting, painting, designing, photographing. We might hear Titans playing music, the Gunn Choir, renowned for their excellence, dressed in their finest, preparing for another show in an exotic locale. The orchestra and jazz ensemble, who showcase Gunn's students' musical talent and represent Gunn with pride in competitions all over the United States. And the band, who started playing on Gunn's opening day in September 1964 and haven't stopped since, playing music that runs the gamut from classical to Adele. We might no longer see the daily flag raising to the call of the bugle or the hotly contested tricycle races that engage the entire campus, but we still see the mutual respect, acceptance, and tolerance that mark Gunn High School. We see that Gunn High School is not just the structures that give it form, not only the staff that give it essence and students that fill it with life and vitality. It is the blend of all the three that define Gunn High School. Most important, we see that Gunn High School is defined by its community and the enjoyment that we all share all day and every day. Imagine all the people
I'm not.